start off as it should be. Page 5. And I'm going to offer up the hand. Stance is all important. Yes? Okay. So I need to shift my weight backwards. So I'm dropping back and down, forward, back, and I'm stepping in to attack the side of the body. We end it here. This angle. This is number one in the form. Okay. Do you want the brakes to do this now? Then carry on with number two? Okay. So I want you all to try. Right. Number two in the form. The same thing. Okay. Nice movements. In. Step in. Around. And move him around. Don't move your hand around. Coming into the horse stance for this. Swap. Okay, I want everybody to have a go at that. The main fault again on this one is people leaning back, and when they're coming in, just to move the hammer and move them. Alright, you got me. So we should go into number three. Okay. First thing the same, the stance is always the same. Okay, well, number three. Right. Grip, step across, step in. It says, finger forearm. Nice and easy. Half turn, grab the wrist, cross. Locking in on the shape. That's easy. In advance, there's all kinds of buildings coming in, all kinds of moves. If he's too tall for you, bring him down. Now do it one more time for this angle. Again, these fingers do their work. Whatever nice. Here you go. Okay. Number 6. Lock it in on the way back. Lock this in. Step in. Do the same one. And cut down. Lock it in, step in, drop down, or you can rotate the hand crank a little bit more. And what you prefer. I use the old Japanese thing, that your hand is your sword. So it becomes my blade right now. Nice and easy. You cut in the center line of the body. You can take it at a different angle. Move it the same way. All you're going to do is hit you. Right? Off you go. There it is. And this is how it was taught to me. Understand? Okay. You're going back. And I'm stripping this off by taking it away here. I can strike in, making a gate. I walk through the gate, turn, and then up. Okay? Now, if he starts to move to relieve that, I'll move with him. If we don't, he'll come around and give me a back on the back of the head. With the other arm. Thank you. But again, our little thing that we can do with this, with the pinky here, as it goes up on the fingers, it's okay. But what I tend to do, build this off, come under here, and I'll rotate them around to make sure I'm clear. When I come back in, this is going to be an angle. Scooping it off. Strike. Move through. Lock it up. So you get this elbow high, and there's lots of other things. There's compressions coming from the rest of the way today. Over. The next one. Mine is very much the same. Yeah, big circle. I'm not putting it into this hand this time, I'm pushing this in here and doing the same thing on this side. Top of the leg, bottom of the leg, pushing. By the main things, 8, 9, and 10 are takedowns. Very basic takedowns. What I'm going to do is put more down, just to save a little bit of time. We've got inside leg takedown, outside leg takedown, and shin bar. So I'm going to do 8, 9, and 10, then we're going to apply. Here, we're disposing of the hand. We don't need it. I'm circling it around and taking it away. Taking it in. Holding the key out of the tank. Push and pull. Looking at a different angle. Can't mess with it too much. It's a big circle. Have it into this hand. Lock it in. And here. You can power into that if you're active. I'm not active. Now, number 10 is what we call a shin bar. This is a seating move. So I'm bringing this round. I'm coming in, locking the iron. And then. Do what you like with this bit here. Okay, I'm going to grab it from up here. But you're dropping in behind and try and put your knee onto your toe. 8, 9, and 10. Don't push.